distance so that they don't have to go on roads anymore and get hit by cars.
Oh yeah.
Scene number one.
Alright guys, time for the therapy session to start. So can you please put down these? Thank you very much. They don't need to sign any more petitions. Oh, please can you just finish this race? Okay, we've got enough screen time. Please can you put that down so I'm getting the audience, please? Right, put them down. They don't need to be labelled anymore, okay? I'm sure half of this audience already labelled them. Guys.
You need a label.
What was that? Was that an accidental slip up there? Huh?
Right, look. Just...
Let's play it. She's doing something else. She's doing something else. We're going to race.
Alcoholism. Stay away from it. Try weed instead.
This is for you. You need to stop that. You can journal it out or something. Okay. Yeah, right. Look, I've already packed the grinder. Grinder's packed. Go. You, enough screen time. How about some mindful colouring? Thank you very much. Hi, everyone. Hello, and thank you for coming to this interactive therapy session. Now, we do have some housekeeping things before we start. So there are no fire exits planned, so you just follow the little green men. COVID restrictions, unless you are medically exempt, please stay in your mask. This counts as physical activity and cinema seating, aka the government just doesn't want to cancel Christmas again. So trigger warning, this show has very strong language and themes of suicide, so...
If you don't like it, get out, and the tickets are not refunded.
That, what she just said, a bit bluntly there. There is no interval, drinks must be kept in plastic cups. The show is 1 hour 15, unless one of you like wants to share your life story, in which case we'll be here till midnight. And this is a new show. Some of us are on cue cards and or scripts, just the nature of an original play. Another thing to do with an original play is we would love some feedback. If anybody would like to write a little feedback form, even if it's just a smiley face, anything's appreciated. Or a sad face too, that's cool too. And this show is being filmed for quality and training purposes. Mostly for those at home with COVID. Hi! Okay, so this isn't a normal therapy session. It's not everyone's ideas of recovery involve bringing their brains to life on stage. But for someone with 2 degrees in theatre who had a mental breakdown at drama school and hasn't been back on stage since, it seemed like a great idea at the time. So, who here has seen the film this is based on? My favourite film in the world, Inside Out. Has anyone actually seen it? Yay! Okay, so you'll know that this is set inside of the brain of a young girl. And I've had to edit my characters slightly to represent the struggles of adult life. So hopefully there'll be a lot of relatable content. And if not, then just enjoy me making a tit out of myself as I overshare my mental health story with you all. So without further ado, it's time to meet the voices inside of my head. Who's up first?
I want to be first.
Oh, go on, Amygdala, thank you.
I mean, what if no one likes the show? I only got 2 likes on the last meet my shed. I mean, no one gets me. I can't go out there.
Like, you were literally just speaking to them all before.
That was different. The show hadn't started yet.
Come on, you can do this. I believe in you.
Yes, liquid courage. That's it. Let's go.
It feels like an elephant sat up on my chest. Spit 3 or 4 words at a minute best. Yet everyone else seems to have enough breath. So why does it feel like I'm so close to losing control? To the source, controlling the mind, hacking through viruses, hoping to find a heart rate that's going to this anxious mind.
All right, come on then. Now who's a brave Griffin?
I'm a brave Gryffindor.
Hi.
I'm Amy. Godilla. And the amygdala is the part of the brain that's like the emotional control center for identifying and responding to threats. So, I'm always ready for battle. If you need a risk assessment done, I am your guy. I got all the emotional responses on speed dial, such as your fight or flight response.
My name is Sarah. Tone in. The last remaining cell. Sarcasm and dark humor is where I dwell. The lack of grin makes me a Slytherin. I didn't ask to be here, nor do I wish to stay. But this bitch keeps me here every fucking day. She's all, let's go to therapy. I'm like, get your hands off me. I am not interested in anything. I have no idea why. But I think we're better off if we all just die, right? Right?
No.
There's no getting rid of me. I've been here since the age of 6. After Dad left for heaven, and that was it. A young, developing brain can't process the pain. So I was employed, and all the joy fleeted. And the memories of my dad, erased, deleted.
Still over-exaggerating slightly there. Your tragic backstory is just that, a backstory. Victim mentality gets you nowhere. All right, don't shoot, I'm just a chemical messenger. My name's Dopamine, and I'm pretty freaking dope. We neurotransmitters help mediate this shit show. Now, the advice is concrete that you are what you eat. Well, same fact applies to the brain. You feel how you think when your life's on the brink and it's up to you to change. Your therapist can talk away every week, blah, 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 but if you don't make a conscious effort to engage with them, then you're not going to get very far. Now, I'm not much of a drinker, more of a forward thinker. The fact that I'm a fighter makes for a good writer. I'm full of facts and strategies, Ravenclaw, obviously. Pansexual, polyamorous, my love is hard to measure. Let's just say I play a big role in creating pleasure. Wanna die? Keep calm and have a smoke. Therapy show, I know. Was only a joke.
Oh, is it my turn now?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Fine. Go on
yes.
Then.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys.
Yeah.
Hi.
Gotta say hi. Say hi to you.
Hi! My name is Noradrenaline, and I like writing poems. My favorite things are unicorns, mermaids, and rainbows, art attack and dominoes, pizza, chips, and animals, Disney films and musicals, picture books and colorings. A loyal Hufflepuff. Oh, look at shiny thing. Sorry, sir. A few weeks into drama school, I hadn't been there long. I'm called into the office, and I'm told that something's wrong. They've made an appointment with educational psychologist. Yes. I read some words and numbers, filling bits of brain test. I mean, I always been a clumsy kid, no knowing right and left. But now I understand why I took 5 driving tests. I have a dyspraxia, which is defined in dictionary. It's disorder of brain affecting coordination of thought and memory. And then she proceeds to tell me I have mild dyslexia too, which makes sense, cause full disclosure, I actually never finished that book. And then she tells me I have ADHD. This must be the reason I didn't get good GCACs. As the years went on, I just kept collecting labels, drowning in disorders and being class disabled. Post-traumatic holding borderline. What is wrong with this brain of mine?
Can we just fast forward to like 2021?
Oh yes. Then I was diagnosed with ASD, which is autism spectrum disorder. Yes, formerly known as Asperger's syndrome, as the female.
Hang on a minute! Don't just skip past 5 years. Those were 5 very important years. Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you, but I can't remember them, to be honest.
No. Now, come on, guys. Remember, we're here to practice some therapy techniques. We don't want to be a selfish diva sharing our sob story.
Well, our sob story is what's going to make us a cracking therapist, actually.
Yes. Do you want to hear our X-Factor sob story?
How about we take a vote, because maybe some of them don't want to hear all of it.
It all started when I was 6 years old.
And she's away.
I lost my dad to cancer and my mom went into a depression.
Hang on a second. We just need to fast forward to drama school, okay?
I didn't know other 14-year-old went trying to kill themselves.
Okay, keep going.
Happy to finally be in one of the world's best performing arts college.
Be the tempo slightly over here all day.
Along with all the lemons life threw at me that year, processing this information that I was different obliterated that little self-esteem I had left. I believe I fell a victim of my lecturer's unconscious bias. Ironically, that was the topic of my dissertation, so along with everything else, this realization triggered a 9-year torment of suicidal breakdown.
I said suicidal breakdown, guys.
I was diagnosed with depression and anxiety, given antidepressant, and graduated to the skin of my teeth 4 months later. And I spent the next 2 years dotting around the country, losing friends, jobs, and house, until I put two and two together as to why I randomly projectile vomited whenever I heard a male Scottish accent.
Did I really have PTSD from drama school?
You did. I mean, can you get any more pathetic?
Oh, I may have graduated
from... My story. Back off. I may have graduated with a first-class degree, but I also graduated with PTSD.
Try explaining that one to your therapist.
I tried to access therapy, but as a self-employed artist doting around the country on a short-term contract, then sorry. Unless you can afford it privately, then there's no NHS
without a permanent address.
Well, I thought maybe I could just sing on a cruise ship for a year so that I could pay for my therapy, but wrong again. Good luck finding a doctor that will sign up for suicidal wreck going to sing at the sea for 6 months.
So...
Well, after 7 diagnoses, six
suicide attempts.
5 job losses.
4 NHS waiting lists.
3 house moves.
And 2 charities later.
Shout out to BAPAM, British Association for Performing Arts Medicine, who helped me to obtain a grant for therapy through the charity Help Musicians UK.
One very sad and confused human ended up leaving London, packed up the labels, came back to Newcastle, surrendered to the government, got a house, only to be met with...
A global pandemic!
Sanitize yourself!
Stop! What are you doing? Get back in the house. Here's a cat. Some universal credit. Now go sort your head out, okay? After 4 years of begging, I'm finally in therapy!
And just by sitting in this room with this woman, it means that all of my anxiety and depression is just going to fly away, right?
Getting therapy is the only first hurdle. It has to get worse before it gets better.
I know it's the 21st century and dogs are going to be driving cars soon. But scientists aren't all the way there when it comes to understanding how our own brains work yet.
Imagine the evolutionary timeline of medicine. Yeah, there you go. Now, in the year 2021, where we are currently, brain medication is roughly at the same stage antibiotics were in the Victorian era. So, if you're sitting there thinking, I've been taking these pills for ages now and they really don't seem to be doing anything, then let that fact sink in.
And if the professionals haven't even figured out yet, then no wonder we're all running around trying to cross the road like headless chickens.
Hang on. So why does this millennial snowflake covered in labels with a degree in jazz hands think that she could help others with their mental health?
Oh, the musical future was my obsession. It was so devastating to graduate with an anxiety attack wherever I engage. With the industry, I dedicated my life.
Fortunately though, my diagnosis created a new obsession.
Fixing the brain.
For the last 2 years, I've been YouTubing, vlogging, soaking everything up, and now I'm a psychology student, so no, it wasn't just a phase.
Now, enough about me.
Everyone has an X Factor sub story.
Everyone's been in a toxic relationship.
Everyone's got their own shit going on.
We've all been in that victim mentality before, thinking we've been so hard done by the universe. Oh, why me, my...
Stepdad was abusive.
Mum was an alcoholic.
Brother committed suicide.
Whatever it is...
Oh, sorry, Cyril, but finding out that Santa Claus isn't real is a very traumatic time for some children, you know?
Not that we ever undermine anyone's struggles, okay? It's not about what caused the chemical imbalance. It's about what we do now we've figured it out. So, those of us who cannot afford private therapy are faced
with some options.
Number one. What? Of course you could just
stay as you are.
Oh, my God. Yeah, fine.
Yeah.
on like this. Something has to change.
You look like the kind of person who has like a car or a van that I could just like hide in and just escape all of life's darkest moat.
If you can't stay at the till for your full 5-hour shift, then I'm wondering if this job is for you right now.
No, I'm okay, I promise. Hi, how can I help you? Oh my god, that's my ex-best friend's girlfriend. She was there the night that I... Oh no.
Not that I would recommend that option, I just couldn't hold a job. So the next option is...
Number two! Get help! What? An 8-month waiting list? And I want to die now! What makes you think that I'll still be here in 8 months?
3 days later.
Am I at the top of the list? Am I? Hello? Am I at the top of the list yet? How about now? I mean, a cycle. Oh, I think.
Yes, so we actually received a referral to the ADHD Autism Service, so we've moved you to another waiting list to get you assist, and that'll be around 18 months from now.
I have nothing to swear. Where is that man?
Okay, gotta love that NHS logic. Okay, the next one is
three.
She's just not like in order like I am. I've got my gloves, my mask, my helmet, because you never know when you're going to get in contact with a turtle. Turtles are bad drivers.
Okay, you shut up, I'm busy. Okay, guys, wow. So, turns out I may have this thing called skittle cycle retention, what's it? Discombobulatory personality disorder. Condition. Itis. It only affects like 0.02% of the population, so I must be like an alien or something.
Or there's always number four!
Kill yourself!
This isn't Bandersnatch. We haven't rehearsed like 50 alternative scenes. Because usually there is a right or wrong answer. So, pause!
That was a quicker pause this time. I'm just gonna take that knife from you. Over here, you've got a lovely rainbow earrings. Hello.
You get to roll this knife. I don't think, well, don't worry. So you've seen Harry Potter, you know that bit where Dumbledore's like, probably drinking Harry. That's you. Keep that knife away from them. Do not.
The knife. That is your
thing. Okay.
So that is completely forgot what I'm saying now because your earrings have just totally distracted me. ADHD brain. What was I going to say now? Is he there?
What are we going to do, lovely? Because we've got some options, but I don't know what it is.
Oh, it's the options. Thanks, guys. Okay. You're great. Freeze again. Good job. Good frozen actors. Okay. So. It was asking you the first question. What do we think we do? Number one, two, three, or four? Has anyone got any answers?
Four.
Three. Well, I was always hoping at least one person would say four. I thought about that one quite a few times, but I did land on number two. And then, of course, if you are added to an 18-month waiting list, which is the case when you've got more severe brain issues, it is number... Absolutely. Okay, so self-help can come in many forms. Most people choose to self-medicate, though.
Most of us choose to self-medicate with all sorts of substances, really.
Caffeine!
Nicotine.
Alcohol.
Marijuana!
Stimulants.
Psychedelics.
Sex. Addiction.
Step. Gambling.
exercise.
Microdosing her wouldn't be a bad shout, you know, it's becoming more accepted, like.
Anyway, those of us who choose to self-medicate, either consciously or subconsciously, have already shot themselves in the foot when it comes to axing NHS therapies, as the NHS see your substance misuse as the reason for your ill mental health and not the other way around, so you might not get added to a waiting list until you've gotten it under control.
So, I called this number, and I thought they got it wrong because I'd only ever heard of AA, Alcoholics Anonymous, but doctor's orders. So?
I went to NA?
Narcotics Anonymous.
Hi, my name's Dopamine and I like dope.
Hi, I'm Amy. Goodilla. And sometimes I have as many as 6 panic attacks before breakfast.
Hi, I'm Nora and I don't know why I'm sat in a room with a bunch of scary looking chaps. Rude.
Hi, I'm Serotonin.
But realised, it wasn't weed I was addicted to, rather suicidal thoughts. You see, weed was only tasing them and my anxiety would be back with vengeance the very next morning because you keep needing to replace the fake happiness that you can't create alone, and so people get stuck in this cycle of guilt and then
giving yourself false synthetic happiness isn't the answer, but just trying to get rid of it isn't either. You need to replace it like smokers, patches and vapes. You need to fill that space in your daily routine or find an activity that elicits the same emotional response.
Addiction isn't a problem, it's a symptom of the real problem.
Addiction isn't a problem. It's the symptom of the real problem. Yes, addiction isn't just your local crackhead asking for a change to get to the hospital or that kid who steals from their mom's purse.
Addiction could be your neighbour on their 7 a.m. run.
Hey, for example,
body dysmorphia and eating disorders.
Addiction could be that guy who switches the lights on and off 3 times a day.
AKA obsessive compulsive disorder.
Whatever your brain decided to cling on to, not everyone's coping mechanism is considered a problem.
I carry ketchup with me everywhere I go because one time in first grade, I cried in front of whole school because they didn't have any ketchup left for the fries at lunch and
How about you raise your hand before you speak? Yeah? Sit down. Okay. So, whatever your crutch is, or your coping strategy, or in the NHS group we call it maladaptive behaviour, whatever it is, it classes it as an addiction, depends on the severity of it. So, if it's your physical health, maybe it's your financial health, or your emotional health, the severity of your addiction and the substance, and of course what it is what classes it as a dangerous addiction. So, be it self-harm or having to have toilet roll end side on top,
like that,
everyone's brains have adopted and adapted their own bespoke shield of defense.
Yes, just like we all have our own individual fingerprint, but more importantly, we have individual brains. So things like dreams, like memories, like personality, it's all unique to you.
Yay, thank you for interrupting me again. Lovely, let's check where we are. Okay, so who here knows the difference between counseling and therapy? Because there's quite a big difference. And if you didn't know the difference, you could be quite shocked. Does anybody know, any willing volunteers before I move over here to somewhere? See, yes, so the main difference is counsellors are affordable and therapists are expensive. So a counsellor is there to listen to you in a non-judgmental way, so you can rant all day about Jim from number 12 and how annoying he is, blah, blah, blah. And the counsellor's just, okay, that's great, and they can guide your thinking towards positive places, they can help you identify what caused the stresses, they can suggest some mindful activities, but they are not qualified in psychology necessarily, which is why therapists are more expensive, and they can kind of take, you can guide your brain revisiting all of the upsetting memories
to get to the good memories, so you revisit trauma. So therapy's a lot, there's a lot more at stake in therapy. And of course the main difference, I didn't know the difference when it came to my first experience of help in the form of a university counsellor. So I showed her the bruises from my unhealthy relationship, I told her I tried to kill myself, and she did nothing about it. So that's why I care so much about people knowing the difference, because I would hate for anyone to end up in my situation and be kind of saying all of this serious stuff to a counsellor when you really need a therapist. Yes, the differences between counselling and therapy.
And there are a lot of people out there who find it hard to talk to a stranger about their feelings. But it is a strange concept when you think about it.
Traditional therapy isn't for everyone. That's why I believe it's so important to understand how to care for our brains by ourselves.
And even those of us who can access therapy, it does not last forever.
Once your individual session's over, you gotta figure it out for yourself.
It's like the day you pass your driving test and suddenly there's no one there to tell you if it is safe to proceed onto the roundabout or not.
Thank you. Okay, so when you are your own therapist, you have to learn when to shut your emotions up and start looking at them from a different perspective. Recognizing your states of mind. So you should all have a crib sheet to help you guys. And there's emotional mind.
If I go back in there after they all saw me run out and definitely heard me kick the bin over, they'll never talk to me again.
Equal rights for faggots and dykes. You're killing the planet when you flush those wipes.
I'm sorry, I didn't write the essay. I actually tried to kill myself before it was due, but only ended up in the A&E. And they drove me straight to college, so you can see I did try my best to get out of writing.
Okay, so emotional mind is, as it says, on the tin. That is when your emotions are so strong that they cause you to think and act in a certain way. So your actions are dictated by your strong emotions. Now, over on the other side of the Venn diagram, we have logical mind, sometimes known as rational mind, reasonable mind. I've got a lot of names, that one.
Okay, so they're all sat in class and saw me leave. Some may have noticed I was in distress and some may have not. So if I don't come back in the lecture, I won't have to face judgment, but I'll miss whatever's being taught. But if I do go back in, then it's more than likely that they'll just ignore me like they did the last time.
In 2018 and 2019, UK police recorded 14,491 crimes committed against people because of their sexual orientation, and a further 2,333 committed against transgender people because of their gender identity.
My serotonin levels are so depleted, I wish to end my life. The earth is already overpopulated, so basically I'm doing it a favor by sacrificing myself to Mother Earth.
You said to think with logic, so now I am following logic on Instagram.
Logical mind loves the facts, so think Sheldon from The Big Bang Theory. Think Spock and the Vulcans from Star Trek. Logical mind does not take any emotions into account. They only make assumptions on the facts. So ideally what we want to do is we want to mix logical and rational mind together to create our
wise mind.
A wise mind decision balances both emotional and logical mind to make a decision that results in a beneficial outcome for both parties. So think meeting in the middle, best of both worlds, no harm comes to either, both sides have to agree. Does it make the situation better? Does it bring you to all your values? And is it in towards your goals, and is it in line with your values?
There's no way of knowing who is judging me for my actions, and who knows? Someone may have been feeling the exact same way and I may have triggered them. I'd best go back in there and apologise for actually dropping the microphone before they make me pay for it. Because I'm in debt.
Hashtag boycott Chick-fil-A. Hashtag love is love. Hashtag trans rights are human rights. Hashtag it's okay not to be okay. And post.
Okay.
We've got some options up here.
Ground yourself, ground your mom. have a smoke.
Yeah.
Play some music. Oh, okay. Yeah. Finish with the self-soothe exercise and positive affirmation. Who wrote this?
Oh my god, wise mind, can you just set a fucking good example for 1 minute?
Okay. Don't let the emotions stick around you. You gotta make it feel uncomfortable by loving the shit out of yourself until it leaves you.
I will also do one. Woo-hoo-hoo. Oh. Yes, let's play some happy, cheerful music. Oh, yes.
Therapist.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. Ain't no passing craze.
Technique that I use when I want to die but I don't really want to die, I call it not today
Satan.
It's basically you can have a box, an envelope, a tin, whatever you want, and you've got some self-soothe options in it, so all of the examples apart from have a smoke. And so if anybody is in need of help and they think that they could benefit from their own not today Satan envelope, in this box at the end, come and grab an envelope, and inside it there are loads of little options. So give someone a compliment, have a hot drink, journal it out, whatever. So this box is here for anybody who would like that. But first, let's put what we just learned into action. So we are going to see three reactions to the same event, and it's up to you guys to identify whether they are in reasonable, wise, or logical mind. And also,
Okay,
who's up first, and what's your situation?
There we go.
Yes.
Oh, I have a terrible problem. I double booked the same evening, both for a Tinder date and a night shift in my job. I don't know what to do.
Okay, so we've double booked ourselves, night shift and Tinder date. What's our first reaction?
I don't care, they may fire me, whatever. I just need to get some. New job, I guess.
Okay, hands up for emotional mind. Hands up for wise mind. Hands up for logical mind. Okay, emotional mind it was. Good job, everyone. Next reaction.
No. Cancel the date, go to work. I can't get any honey if I don't get the money.
Okay, hands up for wise mind. And hands up for logical mind. It was indeed logical mind.
Okay. I need to settle the situation. I need to apologize for my mistake. I need to explain the situation and, of course, reschedule to limit the damage.
Hands up for wise mind. Yay! Good job, everybody. Who's up next? And what's our situation?
Right, so, gone to the Mackey's drive-thru.
Yeah. Okay, Mackey's.
Ordered chicken mayo and 20-piece share box and McNugs, right?
Uh-huh.
Well, I've only got 19 nugs and I've got a cheeseburger instead of a chicken mayo.
Oh, I'm sure you can all relate to McDonald's getting our order wrong. What is our first reaction to that?
Well, I have a burger. It's not the right burger, but I won't be going hungry, so I shall eat this burger.
Okay, hands up for, oh, just in time there. Emotional mind, hands up for wise mind, and hands up for logical mind. It was indeed logical mind, good job. Next reaction.
Here, I've only got 19 nugs and I've got a cheeseburger.
burger instead of a chicken meal. What if I was lactose intolerant, eh? No, I don't care that mayonnaise is also a dairy. It's unacceptable. No, I'm not called Karen, I'm called dopamine.
Okay, hands up for emotional mind. Don't be greedy to go any further. Good job, everyone. And our last reaction.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to call them up and see if they can deliver the correct order. And if not, then I'll just ask for a freebie next time.
Good job. Nice, wise mind decision there. Okay, who's up next? And what's our situation?
So, kind of had homework due for Monday, which I left for Sunday, and then got stuck in traffic on Sunday, so didn't get the homework.
So basically,
done
you just didn't do homework?
No.
Okay, what's our first reaction?
I'm sorry, sir, but I got stuck in traffic on a Sunday night, so I couldn't do the homework, but then again, it is my fault for leaving it so late, so I guess I do deserve the detention. At least, I'm gonna look pretty cool in front of Jenny from biology.
Fair dues. Okay, hands up for emotional mind. Hands up for wise mind. And hands up for logical mind. It was wise mind. It was some like, ooh, I don't know. Good job. Okay, next reaction.
Oh, the homework is not done. I suppose I'll have to get an extension. I wonder if any of my teachers are awake at 2 a.m. to answer emails.
Okay, hands up for emotional mind. Hands up for logical mind. It was a logical mind, leaving only...
The homework is not done. That means that I'll be in lots of trouble and Jenny won't think I'm cool. That means I'm going to fail the module, fail the course, not make it into college, not make it into university, and ultimately live in Peter Lee and work at Sports Direct. It's a shithole.
Okay, hands up for emotional mind. Yay, good job. Thank you very much, Victor. Okay, who's up next? What's our situation?
So my sister ate the food that I was saving to eat later.
Oh, sibling ate our food. What's our first reaction?
Okay, so out of everything in this fridge, you decide to eat my food, the one I've been thinking about since I was in class. I was mentally eating it, okay? Now I can't eat it. Why? Because your fat ass ate it. You want something to eat. Okay, I'll give you something to eat. Come here.
Okay, that's a promotional line. Don't think we need to go any further. And our next reaction, please.
All right, I get it. You are hungry. But at least if you want to eat something that's mine, just let me know beforehand so that I can get something else for myself or at least buy you the same thing.
Nice. Hands up for wise mind. Hands up for logical mind. It was indeed wise mind. Good job, everybody. Okay, and our final reaction.
Okay. You ate my food. I have no food. Since everyone in this house wants to eat everything I eat, I won't eat shit. So we are gonna starve and be skinny legends.
Thank you very much. Okay, our hands up for logical minds. Good job. Okay, so I totally forgot what happens next. Oh look, I was just like really behind. Okay, there we go. So I was just a very much.
You call it as babies next.
Yes, it was the metaphor. I was just finding my lights up one second. So. Back to my metaphors, but when a baby is crying, you can't just ask it what's wrong. You've got to figure it out yourself. Are they
hungry?
Too hot?
Too cold?
Needs changing.
So some of us babies with like unregulated emotions, we struggle to identify what made us react in a certain way.
Oh yes, if it would be that easy to change the way we feel. Imagine, humanity would live in peace, and the planet would be safe, and we...
It's hard to change the way we feel.
Thank you. Sit down again, please. Thank you. Basically, by changing the way we think and behave, we hope this will in turn change the way we feel. Now, we do this with the widely known... Whoa! We don't... Break the remote, I'm so sorry.
Why?
She said,
I always break those remotes.
We do this with the widely known cognitive triangle. So these are all interconnected. So thoughts create feelings, feelings create behaviors, behaviors create thoughts, so on and so forth. What we think affects what we do, and what we do affects how we feel. Go and sit down now. Basically, they are all caused and affected by each other on any given day. And of course, it's your job to differentiate them. So like before, we're gonna see three things and it's up to you guys to see whether that was a thought, a feeling, or a behavior. So I made an example for my own, which was I overhear a trigger at work. This makes me feel sad. Now I am sad, I am in a bad mood. So now I'm in a bad mood, I snap at a kid. And now I've snapped at a kid, that kid now goes and cries.
No, it's you, you snapped at me.
And so I feel like a piece of shit and I need to go home and get high. So that's how one thing in your day can add to the cycle and make it a bad day. So what's our first thing?
Oh no, I dropped my friend's phone.
So we've dropped our friend's phone. What do you think that is? A thought, a behavior, or a feeling? It's a behavior, yes. I'm thinking of dropping my friend's phone. What's the next one?
I am so clumsy.
So clumsy, is that a thought or a feeling? It is a thought. Good job.
I'm so sad. I can't do anything right.
That is, of course, a... Yes. Thank you very much. Who's up next?
First thing, you need kind of nervous.
Nervous is a? Yeah.
I think everyone's gonna judge me.
Is a?
Judgmental. I'm acting out of character.
Acting out of character is a behavior. Thank you very much. Okay, what have we got next?
Tired.
I'm tired. Feeling.
I'm acting moody in front of my friends.
Acting moody. Behaviour.
Now I'm questioning as to whether I might have lost their respect.
Have I lost their respect? Is a thought. Okay, so I'm aware that I'm teaching you all how to think negatively. So could we just like switch that up and pretend that that first one happened and you noticed that and you knew your cognitive triangle?
Okay. So I'm feeling tired, yeah. But I recognise I'm feeling
tired. You recognise you're feeling tired?
And that it's making me behave moody.
Uh-huh.
So in order to counteract that, I will grab myself a coffee.
Absolutely.
And start taking things slow.
Yes.
But my new thought now is how much in debt am I going to be to Starbucks because I bought a lot of sugary stuff.
Fair dues, that's a fair thought. Okay, thank you very much. Last but not least, what's our first one?
Right, so I'm at a party and I'm thinking that everyone will judge me, basically.
Is a judgment thought? Yes.
I'm really scared of rejection.
Is a feeling.
And so I start to socially withdraw from everyone before they can actually reject me.
Which is it? Woohoo! Okay, and can we turn yours around to a positive?
Okay, so again, at the party, assuming everyone will judge me, I recognise that this fear is unwarranted.
Yes.
And so I go out and talk to people and socialise to get over it.
Woo! They came up with all of them themselves. Good job, everybody. Round of applause for the actors here in therapy. Back into character. Okay, so that makes sense, right? Therapy aims to break the cycle and changing the rest, well, changing one of these, hopefully, you see how the rest will follow. So just because we've identified what negative thinking patterns have led to our state of mind, that doesn't necessarily mean that we are fixed.
Anxiety attack!
Okay, so pause! These things used to absolutely floor me, but now my autopilot has therapy techniques ingrained and I can stop myself. But when you just started therapy, you know, therapists can say, oh, try this, try this, try this. But when you are actually having a bloody panic attack, can you remember? Can you heck? So that's why the audience, you've got some colourful envelopes dotted around, and they are going to help us remember what to do in our time of panic. So
So if you have an envelope and you are uncomfortable reading aloud, just pass it to somebody who is. Okay, so who we got first? We're gonna unpause dopamine first.
I just feel a bit dizzy, that's all.
So some people might not know that they're actually having an anxiety attack because it shows itself through everyday discomforts like dizziness, nausea, forgetfulness, hot and cold chills.
I feel a bit sick. It must have been those really old sandwiches in the fridge that I ate. I need to throw them out.
Keep not in any immediate danger. So it's more of a 111 than a 999, but that doesn't mean it's not going to develop into something more serious in the future. So what we need to do is we need to kind of do ourselves a little MOT. When you think, oh, what's wrong with me? MOT yourself. Who has the green envelope labeled self-care? It is over here. Would you like to read this out for me? Thank you very much. I'll just dance for you while you text it out.
And the nominations are...
I hope me.
Self-care comes in many forms, but in dialectical behavioural therapy, we use this rather annoying acronym called PLEASE.
Yes.
To help us remember the basics. PL, physical illness.
So, PL, physical illness. So you've got to think, oh, have I got any niggles? Is my muscles hurting from the gym 3 days ago? Next.
E. Eat healthy.
Eat healthy, goes without saying. You are what you eat. What you put in is your fuel.
A, avoid mood-altering substances.
Yeah, I'm really good at that one. Next.
S, sleep.
Sleep! Get enough sleep, guys. Goes without saying.
E, exercise.
Exercise. Okay, thank you very much. So, that makes sense. MOT, self-care. Anyone who knows DBT will know our annoying acronym of PLEASE. Okay, thank you very much, dopamine. Okay, next let's unpause noradrenaline.
Trick, slick,
so
trick,
some
trick,
people trick, will just trick, let it all fall. The floodgates open and they just can't hold it in anymore. Don't be mad, just be dead sad, love mad. Hello, jingle, mingle, mumble, booby, shramble, no man. Who has the yellow envelope labeled Tic Tac? Yeah, over here, what does it say?
Direct your energy by participating fully in exercise you enjoy, for example, exercise sports, singing, playing music, dancing, walking, cycling, art, etc. Even masturbation, sex counts too.
Thank you very much. Very adult audience here. Only one smirk and snigger. Okay, so you need to redirect your energy. Do whatever you want to do. You can literally run up the stairs and back. There's an intense exercise. So everybody who wants to, stand up. We're going to redirect our energy. Okay, nobody's going to stand up. You two are going to stand up at the front. Drama Society, up you come. Okay, thank you very much. So what we're going to do is we're going to redirect our energy. Who here knows the Macarena? I was an awkward kid at Christmas parties, so I actually had to learn the Macarena before this show. Hit it, Rob.
What a wonderful phrase.
Dangerous kind of anxiety attacks. You just... You just can't talk. It's a survival skill that has persisted throughout human evolution as the tried and tested method of playing dead. So, who has the blue envelope labelled... It's blank. It's just a blue envelope. What have we got?
Mindful grounding techniques. Senses, three things you can see, hear, smell, taste, and feel. And then colours.
That's my favourite.
To find something red, Orange, yellow, green,
blue, yellow, purple. Anyone got a purple?
Who's got purple?
Who's got pink? You're wearing pink. Yay, thank you. Okay, so that's my favourite one. I like to look at the colours of the rainbow, but you also do the sensors. Whatever works for you. Everyone's got different grounding techniques. Okay, thank you very much, serotonin. And last but not least, pause amygdala. So some people have the more widely known kind of panic attack.
You can't catch your breath, and it feels like your heart is going to jump out of your chest, and you can't catch your breath, and your chest really hurts,
and you can't catch your breath. Okay, thank you very much. So, who has the red envelope label? Panic attack! Hello.
Eight, breathing. Breathe in for 8 seconds.
Uh-huh.
Hold for 8 seconds, then
breathe out. Okay. Did you hear that, everyone? We're gonna do some paced breathing together. We are gonna breathe in for 8 counts, then we're gonna hold it for 8 counts, then we're gonna breathe out for 8 counts. You can do this with your eyes closed if you would like to. Hit it.
Fears like viruses also is what experts are calling post-lockdown anxiety.
The real pandemic is mental health.
So the world is a mess in more ways than one, but how can we fix it with our sanity gone? The reason everyone goes on and on about the importance of breathing is because it's the first response cue for when your anxiety attacks and your fight or flight is triggered. The only difference is we're not cavemen anymore, being chased by a saber-toothed tiger. So deep breathing, it convinces the brain to call off the attack. It sends signals to the body to put that adrenaline back, because you can't run from your taxes, and crying like a toddler isn't going to get that essay handed in any sooner. So call me brave or call me stupid. Why not try some deep breaths with me? I'm gonna breathe in for 8 counts, then hold for 8 counts, and then out for 8 counts. You ready? Out. In 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Recall breath, 2 seconds rest. Yes, we're gonna do it again. In 2, 3, 4. I know this all sounds cliche. Hold 2, 3, 4, but it works. What can I say? And out 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Keep calm and carry on again. Mindfully notice the thoughts in your head. They just want attention, so put them to bed. Put down your anxiety, come and fly away with me. Everybody wants to see you fall. So put down your anxiety, just come on and breathe with me. Show that overactive amygdala who's the boss of that brain. Thanks, guys. Hopefully that helps some people's regulation of stress. Phew, okay, so these are just my examples of the way that my body reacts to the emotion of fear. You might have related to all of those, you might have related to none of those. Whatever it is that you're feeling, it's this. Usually our amygdala has overestimated the level of threat, and he sends signals to the body to get all the systems fired up and ready to react accordingly. Now, we all know the famous fight or flight response. Well, there are actually a couple of more. Thank you, amygdala. Okay, the first one we have is fight!
Physically fighting, pushing, shoving. Whoa. And fighting verbally. For example, ladies, saying no.
There's flight.
Putting distance between yourself and the danger, such as by backing away, hiding, or straight up running the fuck away.
There's also freeze.
Going still, dead, and silent. This is a common response to sexual violence and rape. Animals often freeze to avoid fight and potential further harm, or to play dead, and so to avoid being seen and even murder predator.
And yes.
Except your muscles become loose and your body goes floppy. This is an automatic reaction that can reduce the physical pain what's happening to you. Your mind can also shut down to protect itself. This is also called disassociation, popular among young children.
There's also friends.
Calling for a friend or bystander by shouting for help.
And or
befriending the person who is dangerous, such as by bribing them, or just generally like trying to deal with them, or
pleading with them, because this is instinctive survival mechanism, and I'm shitting myself.
Okay, so sometimes our bodies are in like actual real danger, and you need to let your body work accordingly. We only intervene when we've deemed the response to be unacceptable for the situation. For example,
I don't care if mayonnaise is also a dairy. This is absolutely appalling.
Who here has felt personally victimized by the McDonald's drive-thru not getting your order right? Yes, exactly. So whether you're a friend, flop, freeze, furry, whatever you are, our bodies have got a lot to contend with at 8 a.m. on the platform of Clapham Junction. Now, my body just didn't get the memo. They were just out of panel chocolates and there's not actually a swarm of Vikings running towards my medieval village. So when an anxiety attack is triggered, let's see the same response again, but this time from inside of the brain.
Okay, guys, we got a 2319. I repeat, a 2319. A threat has been identified. I repeat, a threat has been identified. All systems go. Oh, no address. Go, go, go. Fight or flight.
Flight. Flight.
Flight. Now speed up the heart. Speed up the breath. Expand the lung passage and dilate those blood vessels. Tense. Ready for action. Dilate the pupils to enhance vision intake and get that oxygen.
The muscles need
a glass! Oh, shutdowns! Oh, come on, we've got better things to be doing than digesting breakfast. Oh, and turn off all sexual desires. We're trying to run for our lives, we don't want to get distracted. Oh, and definitely, we don't want to be wasting any of that precious prep talking, so shut down Broca's Ariel!
So back in the day, that wreaked absolute havoc on my body. Who here has anxiety? Yeah! Air high fives for you all. So is anyone else feeling they've been hit by a truck after an anxiety attack? Yeah, so does it now make sense when you see what's actually going on inside of your body to make you feel like you have indeed been hit by a truck? Does anyone else have any kind of other symptoms of anxiety that we haven't talked about? Has anyone got any like other random weird ones? Yes, what do you? Irritability, so she's like bringing me to everyone. That means we need to feed her or like breathe her or something if she's being mean to you, everyone. Okay, so now I can ground myself. Let's see the same response again. Post therapy.
Okay, guys, we got a 2319. A threat has been identified. I repeat, a threat has been identified. All systems go. Oh no, adrenaline! Whoa. Go, go, go! Fight or flight?
Flight!
Flight! Flight. Now speed up the heart, okay. Speed up the breath, expand the lung passage and dilate those blood vessels. Tense, ready, but hang on. Just a parking ticket.
Purple pink. Okay, thanks. great. I really, really like the metaphor. You don't have to see the full staircase, just take the first step. So ideally, we want to get to the point where our amygdala doesn't overreact and call it 2319, but at least now post-therapy I can stop myself before the beat drops. Okay, so if anybody would like any references, obviously I'm referencing a lot from The Mind Explained on Netflix. If anyone hasn't seen The Mind Explained on Netflix, great show.
Seriously, that ticket is going to become a problem for me, so we've got to do something now.
I have a great idea. I know what we can do. We just need to
kill ourselves.
Yes,
that's
you.
Boring.
We have any good ideas.
You already told it.
Well, keep reminding you guys it's a fiction.
So,
not if we
spin the wheel!
Spinning the wheel is like my own technical terminology, and it basically means what we want to do is we want to change the emotion. So, to give you a little stripped back scientific perspective of what an emotion is, I've started using this nifty little phrase, and I really like it. So, emotion is just E-motion. It's just energy in motion. It's little chemical signals traveling between neurons control our entire perception of reality. So the way I see it is we need to take in or change the energy. We can do that through things like
endorphins released by exercise and other enjoyable activities.
Other enjoyable activities.
Human
sound. Natural sound.
So all of these things and many more contribute to giving that brain energy a little shake-up. And that's why I call it spin the wheel. Because
severely unregulated emotions.
And black and white thinking.
As though some of you close to us.
Crazy people!
Feel like we never know what's gonna come next.
Jekyll or Hyde? Yeah. So by engaging in spinning the wheel, I have trained my brain to fit spin that metaphorical wheel and choose a new emotion. So the same thing goes for not today's statement. It's just about changing your headspace and thinking, oh, this is not good, I need to do something to distract me. To forget about that. So it is a bit of a short-term fix. So you may have squished that panic attack, yeah, but London parking tickets can be like 3 digits. And now here you are, stood outside of your ticketed car in the middle of central London after an audition that you didn't get a call back for. Now you've got 26 minutes to get to work on the other side of London, which Google Maps says at least 54.
Should
have got the tube.
What we need to do is a little quick grounding exercise. We don't have time to have a bath, we don't have time to do all these things, but we do have time for a quick breathing or colourful exercise. Has anyone got any random, like, 3-second grounding exercises? No? I'm going to introduce you to one of my favourites when I am outside of my ticketed car. So I look at all of the number plates and I just make words out of the number plates. So my number plate is rainbow fairies only ate hippogriffs and unicorns. Or you go, Sally likes only 4 bananas at lunch. Whatever, just say the first words that come to your head. That's what I do when I'm around cars and I need to calm down. Okay.
You know what I want to do with my emotions?
What?
I want to turn them into a show.
No one wants to watch a show about emotions.
Ooh, yes, I've been seen Inside Out again.
Fuck you.
Yeah, okay, so you guys will know that I have no idea what you just said. Be nice to each other.
Security.
She tried to stab me.
Did not, that was so stealthy. I did not see her take the knife. Okay, so basically, we've got the 10 core emotions, people. Okay, so the 5 core emotions are the reason they are called the 5 core emotions, and the reason they are in a Disney film is because they are found in every human of any age across all cultures and languages. So no matter where you're from, no matter what your age, if you are a human, you show these 5 emotions. Obviously, I've given it away a little bit, but can anybody shout out the first 5 core emotions? Yes, anger. Sadness. Happiness. Disgust.
Fear.
Fear, absolutely. Sat right there. Okay, and the next one. So at the end of the film, when they get that new board put in, and it's like, ooh, puppy, and they've got
got loads of new ones, and the balls come and they're like two different colours. That's when we grow up, we get a little bit more complicated and we start to have mixed emotions. So does anybody know the next five emotions?
Love.
Love, absolutely. Love, we could end it with love, guys. Love makes the world go round. I love love. Any other ones?
Hate.
Hate? No. What? That would go in anger. What?
Envy.
Envy, absolutely. Any more? I know it's late, guys. I'm sorry. I'll put it on the board. There you go. They are the 10 core emotions. Now, in an ideal world, we would have time to go through them all like we do in therapy group, and we can talk about how they disguise themselves as other emotions and stuff like that. But unfortunately, it is almost the end of the session. And that means
Wait. The end of session? But we just started.
No,
we're
talking about our feelings with
children. What does that mean for us exactly?
Oh, the end of session means that it's time for an anxiety and depression to leave. Well, thank you and goodbye. Have a nice life. Fuck off.
This is gonna be good.
Excuse me, I've been here longer than you.
Not exactly true.
do we get to say this?
Anxiety attacks. Oh, you're suggesting you're killing yourself, so why are you still here?
Does anyone know what's going on here, metaphorically? Anyone started therapy all wide-eyed, like, so where does the anxiety and depression go away? It doesn't. Okay, so the worst news for anyone currently struggling right now is depression and anxiety don't just go away. Cliche phrase, ready for it? You have to learn to live with it. Yay! Okay, so it does get easier, right? Make friends with your emotions. Don't hate them, don't keep pushing them away. The emotion of fear is here to keep us safe.
Here is that 100-page risk assessment for Planet Earth you asked for.
Thank you very much. Good job. Okay, and the emotion of sadness helps us communicate that we are in distress and that we need help. So, if those of you have seen the film, you'll know that her happiest memory and her saddest memory are in the same core memory pool. So they go along with each other quite often. Basically, you guys have a lot of work to do in recognizing your states of mind, getting out of that cycle of the thoughts and feelings and behaviors, get those grounding techniques ingrained in autopilot, just stop fighting your feelings, give them the stage for an hour, and then tell them to go get changed and put on. Okay, so if anybody has been triggered by all of this suicide talk, now would be a really great time to go to the bathroom. I'm gonna get a chair, because all the drama students in the room are like, oh, you can't do a chair, it's illegal, I've graduated. So I sit in a chair when I do monologues now. Okay, so basically, when I was 14, the Grim Reaper paid me a visit, and I'm like, hey, can I come with you? And he's like, well, sure thing, let me just check your file. Yeah, actually, you're in rubbish sets at school, got no social life at school. Oh, hang on a minute, it says here that you're playing one of the leads in the school musical, is that right? Yes, I do. People smile and clap when I sing, and it is quite a nice feeling. There we go. Okay, so from that moment on, the Grim Reaper drew me up a contract, and it tied my self-esteem to musical theatre. So as long as musical theatre fueled my self-esteem, I could live on planet Earth. And that's how it went from the age of 14 to 22 when I got to drama school. And the Grim Reaper's back again. He's like, hey, bitch, in the 5 years you've been professionally training in musical theatre, you have not had a single lead role. What is up with that? Maybe I was wrong about this musical theatre pathway. And I'm like, yep, I will come with you willingly. 22's a good run. And I actually genuinely tried to go with him like a multitude of times. The first time I tried, I was 14 and my mum knocked on the bathroom door. She's like, come on, Elle, it's time for tea. You've been in there far too long. The second time I got into my car, not legal to drive at all. I might have been high, but I'd never been lower. I just wanted to drive into a wall. The third time, I just sat for hours, numb and barely alive. And then I got cold feet and woke my boyfriend up after I'd only taken about five. The fourth time, I found myself on a roof. I just wanted to see the fall. And that was enough to bring me back down. I mean, that and a teacher knocking on the bathroom wall. The fifth time I tried, I'd just been fired. I lost a lot of faith in humanity that day. The sixth time, I'd just been fired again, and I was ready to get hit by a train. To die would be an awfully big adventure, said Peter Pan. But I don't regret any of my attempts, because without them, I wouldn't be who I am. And you know how people say that giving up is selfish, it's stupid, it's wrong? Half of me agrees with that. But the other half says, well done. Because it's only when I am on the edge of life, edge of roof, pills in hand, it's only then I'm able to see all of the things I'm about to lose, all the things I'll never do or be. And if people can't see that, maybe their Grim Reaper doesn't show them a file and they don't have anything to live for. None of us really know. Maybe it is their time to go. Because unless you've seen their world, we don't know how dark and cold and lonely and frankly fucking shit it is to feel like you are thousands of feet down inside a pit. You can't find a ladder, you don't have a door, the windows are barred, so you just sink to the floor and evaluate yourself. But of course your vision is so impaired because it's too dark to see and there's nobody there except the demons, the gremlins, the dragons or whatever. They have you convinced it will never get better. They make you forget all about your family and friends. The only thing that eases the pain is picturing and planning the end, because there is no such thing as tomorrow. The future just doesn't exist. Only drowning your sorrows in substances is just enough to clear some mist. And whether it's survival of the fittest or how much money you've got in the bank, maybe you've got some friends that still believe in you or a stranger passing by to thank. Be it school, work, family, whatever keeps you on the right track. Some of us keep fighting our dragons no matter how many times they come back. But for those of us who can't, for those who still believe, they will never be fine. It might seem dark and cold right now, but the light will come in time. My dragon isn't dead yet. I've just tamed him with this writing. And who knows? To die might be an awfully big adventure. Just don't give up yet and keep on fighting. So during lockdown, the Grim Reaper's back again. And I'm like, okay, hold on. I know the world's gone to shit and everything and you really want me to come with you, but I have an idea. And I'd drawn up a new contract, still with the theater, but alongside the therapy aspect, adding my own twist to music and drama therapy, and luckily the Grim Reaper agreed. So that night I bought the domain name for cognitive behavioral theatre, and hopefully once I get this degree and get out of my head, I can help therapying people through the form of theatre and music. So I thought of so many ways that I could end this show. I was like, I'm gonna do a cheesy dance number or some like cringy morals or something like that. But of course I had to end it with classic therapy techniques followed by a song. So this one. What we're gonna do is we're gonna learn a technique called the four R's. It's the one at the bottom of your sheet so you don't forget them. There's four R's, and to help you, to just help the visuals in the four R's, I've dressed them up in my favorite R's. The things that begin with R. So without further ado, come on out, guys!
Ring those and run them!
Is he wearing his trousers inside out? Who loves the reference? Woo! Okay!
Sex, drugs, and rock and roll, baby!
And
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer!
Thank you, and last but not least, my favorite, everybody, to stand for
Rasta Rapunzel!
Regulate, so we're gonna use the number of up that mug, you just smashed all over the kitchen. So let's do it again, everybody, and we can all shout it out together. So, react! Then we have regulate! And rationalize! And resolve! One more time, we have react! Regulate! Rationalize! And resolve! Woohoo! Okay, now it actually is the end, guys, I promise. Go on.
You didn't think we were going to end the show just with this, another boring therapy thing.
No, I'm embarrassed. Do we have to?
Okay.
No. We are not leaving this stage until we finish with the proper...
Finish with the true representation of what we really need to do in order to make our brains go from mindful to mindful. We have to be mindful, and when we're being mindful, we need to pay attention. And to pay attention, we need a true representation of what it really feels like to be stuck inside of my brain.
From my new album of the same name,
Mindful, due to release next year.
Find me on SoundCloud under Ellerose.
I lost the key to my imagination. Now my unicorn won't stop.
Ignition on Rainbow Road, causing a 69-minute delay.
No new powder left, I'll never make it to the station. Why my train has come apart? Yes, I live in my own world. But they know me here, so it's okay. I make my own way back to Earth each day to pay my rent, my bills, my council tax, my car insurance, electric, gas, phone, TV, Wi-Fi, I even put a parking fine into one. Prescriptions, Netflix, Disney Plus on time every month, but it's never quite enough because they say I have to pay attention to your random questions for the latest attention. Yes, it's in my best interest. Just pay attention. Oh, so super sorry, Mr. Race, that sign with the clock tab going in our brain at any given time. A couple are responding and a few looping things. My inbox seems a must have zooming down. Hello, Chrome, is anyone? No, Morgan, I'm just trying to be like, what do you mean I'm using all the passwords incorrect? I'm super content you. I don't even know what account that email is on. Where's the blasted music even coming from? I'm so sorry. What were you saying again?
Pay attention
to your random questions for Millennial's retention. Yes, it's in my best interest to pay attention.
Pay attention.
A is for...
What was the question?
D is for Dexter, the winds you up in.
Detention.
H is for how the hell are you? Pay attention! Okay, so what we have to do, we have to pay attention. You're being mindful. You're meditating. It's very important that you pay attention. That's literally all being mindful is. Paying attention.
It's all so crazy.
Being mindful. You can't meditate without paying attention. You're not being mindful. I don't pay attention to anything again.
What's the grounding technique to me? Tell me about it.
Yes, it's in my best interest to speak my guest. I don't protest any feelings of unrest with my stomach and my chest. I do not jest. I try my best to be a pest to pass this test.
Ellerose, if you don't pay attention, you're going to fail those GCSEs and not get into college.
My unicorn is waiting for me. The bell's about to go and oh, I am so ready to go. Tucked up safe inside my head alone for the rest of today, where I don't have to pay.
Get off, won't?
feedback. Again, even if it's just a smiley face or a sad face. Okay, you can fuck off home now. Thank you for coming. We appreciate it. Woo!